आस्मिता शर्मा
और मैं अविनाश
इस सभा में आप सभी का स्वागत करते हैं।
हमारे बीच उपस्थित एसआईएमबी के डायरेक्टर डॉक्टर अस्मिता चिटनिस, एसआईएमबी के डायरेक्टर डॉक्टर धान्या, एसटीएमएचआरडी के डायरेक्टर डॉक्टर प्रतिमा, लेफ्टिनेंट कर्नल कदम सर एवं उपस्थित मेरे सभी मित्रों का हार्दिक स्वागत।
आज हम सब यहाँ एकत्रित हुए हैं स्वतंत्रता दिवस के इस पावन अवसर पर वो एक खुशी मनाने जो 120 करोड़ हिंदुस्तानियों को जोड़े रखती है। ये खुशी उल्लास और जश्न है आजादी का।
जी हाँ, आज है भारत की 70वीं वर्षगांठ, तो आइए और जोर से मेरे साथ बोलिए जय हिंद।
जय हिंद।
भारत 200 साल तक अंग्रेजों का गुलाम रहा। रानी लक्ष्मीबाई, भगत सिंह, राजा राम मोहन रॉय, महात्मा गांधी, ये कुछ नाम उन अनगिनत नामों में से हैं जिन्होंने भारत को आजादी तक का रास्ता दिखाया और आखिरकार 15 अगस्त 1947 के दिन भारत को पहली बार आजादी की किरण दी।
आइए इस दिन की शुरुआत करते हैं भारत के तिरंगे को गगन में ऊंचा लहराकर। इसके लिए मैं आमंत्रित करूंगी डॉक्टर अस्मिता चिटनिस को कि वो आकर ध्वजारोहण करें।
Independence Day. Last week, we also commemorated the great Quit India movement, which completed 75 years. And we all took oath on that day of making new India. That was a great feeling, isn't it? Because this time, it's happening for almost a week. These historic moments generate patriotic feeling. It's a great feeling, that's what I strongly believe in. I must congratulate MHRD for institutionalizing these things. Because unless and until we are aware of these things, that what sacrifices and struggle our forefathers have gone through, we really don't value the freedom that we are enjoying today. And this is a day, rather these moments are the ones where we need to remember these struggles. And also we need to remember one thing, that we have got everything absolutely free. So we are enjoying our comfortable life, where our soldiers are fighting on the border 24/7, protecting our country. So we as citizens, it's our responsibility to carry it well. And then we also need to understand that there are certain things that we also need to perform. Because when we talk about freedom, freedom has got different meanings to different people. Freedom has got two different sides. We say freedom to do something or freedom from something, isn't it? Because freedom is power or right which we get to do something, to speak something, to do whatever we wish to do. So it's very important, it's a responsibility on us to utilize this carefully. Because if I talk about a small child who is going to the school, he might be seeking freedom from his parents' attention when his parents are asking him to study. In class 3 or 4, he's absolutely not interested in studying. Even I was never interested in studying when I was young. He wants to go out and play, right? For a person like you of your age, you are seeking financial freedom. So every one of us is trying to seek freedom from something or to do something. So it's a big thing for us. And in order to get that freedom, we are struggling hard. We are in a big competition. The race begins. When you get up in the morning, your race starts. And it never ends, in fact, because all the while you are trying to achieve something. And you know what? Recently, two things have come into our life, and they are driving our life, in fact. One is mobile, and the other is internet. Last time when I spoke, people will watch for me, I spoke about social media. I can't ignore that. Today also I'm going to talk about it. Because I strongly feel certain things, and I thought I should put forward these things. If you will at least start thinking. Your day starts with a mobile. You can't imagine your day without a mobile, isn't it? It has got extraordinary benefits, no doubt about it. The mobile when it came in India, I think it's 1996-97, all of you were very young. Privileged few had that handset. And that handset was heavier than your cordless phone. It was a big instrument, you see. And the incoming call was 8 rupees per minute, and outgoing was 16 rupees per minute, where the salary typically was around 2,000. But it had excellent advantage because you were connected. That was a great feeling. But it had only two features, two or three maximum, I would say. It had the clock, calendar, and just calling. Those were the only features. Now we see so many features coming in and getting added day by day. Internet is another thing which has become an integral part of our life. So when you get up, you look at your mobile. Rather, I would say half of your working time goes in picking up your mobile, checking it, some other different things, and putting it back. Right? Because there are WhatsApp messages to look at. And basically what happens, when I put something on my WhatsApp, I spend my energy in looking at whether the message has been delivered. So there are two gray ticks. Then I spend my energy to check whether it gets converted into blue. Right? Then I spend another some time to check how that person is going to respond. Right? And if a person responds, then I would say, see whether that response is as per my expectation or not. Isn't it? And if he doesn't respond, then that's another headache. Isn't it? So many things to do. The same goes on Facebook. I'm putting something, I'm checking out insurance for water, for dinner. Who the hell is interested? No, nobody's interested. Because there is so much of information which is coming your way, which you are not interested. And then you wait for people to like it. And then you evaluate yourself on the basis of how many likes you are getting. And not you're on Snapchat or anything that good, you really don't know how different it is or how good it is. But my point is, we are spending so much of time on these things that we are losing out on small things, like we don't have time to listen to a good piece of music. We do not have time to even sing if you want to sing. We do not have time to look at nature around us, isn't it? Because we are constantly in some race. And if you also carefully, most of us are always trying to prove something to others. We are not trying to prove something to us, isn't it? We are always walked down by peer pressure. We are always walked down by expectations of our parents or our loved ones or our boyfriend or girlfriend, whoever it is. We are always trying to prove something to somebody. There are very few people who actually are self-driven, who actually don't care about what others say. I'm not saying don't bother about others. Of course, you have to bother about others. You need to live up to some expectations. But the point is, because somebody is doing something, there is absolutely no need to do it. Try to get some small pleasures in your life. Try to just sit back a while retrospect, take a pause and see whether you are actually doing what you are supposed to do. Because at this stage, I'm talking about these students, there's a lot of expectations from everyone around you. It's not possible to fulfill all those expectations. I don't think it's possible. And don't be impatient. The problem is you guys are extra brilliant. You are smarter than us. It's really difficult for us to be smarter than you. But the fact is, everything has its own time in life. And you have to hard earn it. Because that's the greatest enjoyment you can derive when you hard earn it. Because you have value for that. And there are communities in the world, I don't know whether you know Mormons or whether you Amish community from Germany. They live such a restricted life and disciplined life. I'm not saying that you follow that life. But the point I'm trying to drive is there are people who live a very simple life. Ultimately, when you came here, it was not your choice. When you are going to exit this world, again, it's not your choice. But the fact is, when you exit, you cannot take anything with you. So look at others who are less privileged, and then you will understand and appreciate the fact that you are so privileged. So wish you all the best. I'm sure you have every power and will to achieve what you want to achieve. But be happy, enjoy every single moment. You will definitely, definitely will reach the destination. God bless you. Thank you all.
यहाँ पर उपस्थित सभी डायरेक्टर्स, टीचिंग स्टाफ, नॉन टीचिंग स्टाफ और स्टूडेंट्स और बच्चों को बहुत बहुत शुभकामनाएं देता हूं। आज भारत को आजाद होकर 70 साल हो गए। 70 साल के बीच में बहुत कुछ इस देश ने पाया है, बहुत कुछ कमाया है और बहुत कुछ कमाने लायक रह भी गया है। जो कमाया है उनमें से कुछ चीजें ग्रीन रेवोल्यूशन, आईटी रेवोल्यूशन, इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर रेवोल्यूशन, ग्लोबलाइजेशन और अभी जो चल रहा है डिजिटलाइजेशन, डीमोनेटाइजेशन, ई करप्शन वगैरह वगैरह, और ये सिलसिला चलता रहेगा। ये जब 1947 में आजादी मिली थी तो उसको आजादी दिलाने के लिए 20-22 साल पहले ये सोच जनता के बीच में घूमनी शुरू हो गई थी कि आजाद होना है अंग्रेजों से, और फिर 1942 में इसका एक संकल्प किया गया है निश्चय कि आजादी प्राप्त करनी ही है, और 5 साल के क्रांति के बाद वो प्राप्त हो गई। 9 अगस्त 1947 को ये प्राप्त हो गई, उसको क्रांति दिन कहते हैं। जिस जगह पर यह पार्लियामेंट की गई उसको क्रांति मैदान कहते हैं, और हम लोगों को अभी अगले 5 साल के बाद जो 75 डायमंड जुबली मनाएंगे तब तक और संकल्प करने लिए ताकि आप सिद्धि की ओर पहुंच जाए। ये मेरी बात नहीं है, ये श्री नरेंद्र मोदी की मन की बात है जो मैं आपके सामने रख रहा हूं। अब देखिए मेरी मन की बात, मैं आपको यही संदेश देना चाहता हूं, स्टूडेंट्स की लाइफ में एजुकेशन सबसे इंपॉर्टेंट है और एजुकेशन के साथ वैल्यूज होना ये और भी ज्यादा इंपॉर्टेंट है, क्योंकि सिर्फ एजुकेशन विदाउट वैल्यू एक केवल इंफॉर्मेशन कहलाता है। अगर ये एजुकेशन के साथ में वैल्यूज और आइडियल्स भी अगर मिक्स कर दिए जाए तो फिर वो नॉलेज बनता है, और इस देश को उज्ज्वल बनाने के लिए एक नॉलेजेबल युवा पीढ़ी की जरूरत है, जो खास कर निश्चित रूप से आप भविष्य इस देश का बदल सकते हैं। आपके पास और 5 साल है और उसके बाद फिर 25 साल है, और इस समय के अंदर किसी को भी यहाँ पर उपस्थित है उसको बिल्कुल भी संदेह नहीं होगा कि भारत इस पूरे दुनिया के अंदर एक बहुत शक्तिशाली देश के तौर पर उभर आएगा।
ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ गांधी ग्रुप I wish you all a very happy Independence Day. I won't be taking more than 2 minutes, don't worry. Actually, in our endeavor to continuously improve our services, we have prepared a handout which will benefit the guards and they will be able to refresh and use it as a refresher guide. So we are using this occasion to launch the pamphlet, and I would like to request the dignitaries on the stage, the three directors and Colonel Kadam, to kindly launch the handout. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.